Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to talk about how to treat low blood sugar. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes friendly recipes for everyone. Now you may think this is a weird question for a diabetes channel to tackle, but a 2015 study by Chloe Eldridge found that current evidence shows hypoglycemia is considerably prevalent amongst people with type 2 diabetes, especially those on insulin, yet still fairly common for other treatment regimens. This highlights the subsequent need for educational intervention and individualization of therapies to reduce the risk of hypoglycemia. Now first, let's define what we mean by hypoglycemia. Hypoglycemia happens when the amount of blood glucose or sugar in your blood drops to a level that's too low to sustain normal functioning. In most people, this is defined as a blood sugar level below 70 milligrams per deciliter. Now, left untreated, hypoglycemia can lead to coma and even death. It is a very, very serious condition, and it's very important that those with diabetes monitor sugar levels and treat hypoglycemia when it is present and right away. It happens more often than we think. So today, I want to look at the most common risk of hypoglycemia, the symptoms, and then what you need to do to treat the condition. Now, you are at risk of having low blood sugar reaction if you have one of the following. If you skip or delay a meal or snack, this is why it is so important for you to make sure you eat. I know the temptation to lose weight and other factors may cause you to not eat as regularly as you should, but it is so important that you eat three meals a day and eat your snacks in between meals. This is to maintain a steady, even blood sugar level. If you take too much insulin or eat too few carbs. Now we've all made a mistake in our dosage of insulin. You take it when you're half asleep or you're just in a hurry. It happens. Don't try to pretend you didn't make the mistake. It's fine. Just correct it. Also, in many of my videos, I've stated that you must eat carbs. That is one reason a very low carb diet is not good for diabetes. It will really mess up your blood glucose regulating system. Trust me, I know that one from experience. Eat the carbs. You need them. When you do exercise, you are burning off carbs and sugars. And this is great, but know that with your exercise comes a possibility for your blood sugar to drop dramatically. Get into the habit of checking your blood sugar before, during, if possible, and after your exercise period, and be prepared. Have a carb snack ready to get that sugar back up. When you drink alcohol, especially without eating carbohydrates, you are at risk of hypoglycemia. Now, I've done extensive research on this topic, and I've written about it, and I've included the information in several of our videos. If you are going to drink alcohol, you must do so with food. Drink with a meal, or at the very least, with snacks. Alcohol can bring down blood glucose levels drastically, and at times the symptoms of hypoglycemia are often mistaken for drunkenness, even if you're not intoxicated. You need to check your blood glucose levels if you have any of the following symptoms: weakness and/or fatigue, headaches, sweating, anxiety, dizziness, shaking, and an increased heart rate. Now, if you have hypoglycemia, you check your blood sugar, and it's less than 70 milligrams per deciliter, then you need to follow the 15-15 rule. Very simple to follow, 15-15. You eat 15 grams of carbs, then rest for 15 minutes, then recheck your blood sugar. Now, if your blood sugar is still less than 100, take another 15 grams of carbs and retest your blood sugar after a 15-minute rest. And you repeat this as often as you need to until your blood sugar is 100 or better. It's important to note that if you have frequent low blood sugars, you need to speak to your doctor. You may need to change your medication or your meal plan. I want to give you a quick carbohydrate guide for treating low blood sugars. If your blood sugar is less than 70, as we said, you need 15 grams of quickly absorbed carbohydrates, and I'm going to give you a list. Each of the following provides approximately 15 grams of carbs. And you may want to get a pen and pencil, write some of these down, because it would be good to keep them with you just in case you're out and about and your blood sugar drops. In the candy department, 5 small gumdrops are 15 carbs, as are 12 gummy bears, 6 large jelly beans, 5 Lifesavers, 15 Skittles, a tablespoon of honey jam or jelly. I know it's not really candy, but it's in the candy topic for us here today. 1 tablespoon of sugar in water, or 4 Starburst. Now, I'm sure that if you have any of those candies with you, you'd rather do that than the sugar in water, but that's if you absolutely have to. But that is the list of candies. All of those contain 15 grams of carbs. As far as beverages go, 1/2 cup of apple juice, 1/2 cup of orange or grapefruit juice, 1/2 cup of pineapple juice, 1/2 cup of regular soda or pop, not diet, and that's about 2/3 of a can, 1/3 cup of grape juice, 1/3 cup of cranberry juice, 1/3 cup of prune juice, or 1/4 cup of skim milk. Those are the beverages that you could have to bring your blood sugar up. As far as fruits go, 1/2 banana, 1 small apple, 1 small orange, 1/2 cup of applesauce, 2 tablespoons of raisins, or 15 grapes. Any of those contain 15 grams of carbs and will bring your blood sugar up. Also, you may keep glucose tablets with you. 3 to 4 glucose tablets will contain 15 carbs, and there is now a tube of glucose gel that is pre-measured to be 15 carbs, and you can purchase those at many drugstores. Now, these foods that I've given you are easily absorbed and will raise blood sugar levels quickly. Now, there are other foods that will raise your blood sugar, but a lot of times they contain protein or fat, and they don't raise it very quickly. This would include chocolate, candy bars, ice cream, cookies, crackers with peanut butter or cheese, and bread. They just don't work as fast. They will work, but I suggest you use the list that I have given you. Now, if you have type 1 diabetes, and some folks with type 2, this may fall into your category as well, and you don't take care of your low blood glucose, you could pass out. If you do, there is a drug called glucagon that should be injected into your skin like you do with insulin. Now, this can be done by a family member or a friend who has been taught to do it. You should always have someone with you who knows how to give you a glucagon shot. Now, glucagon may cause you to vomit, so you should be placed on your side when the injection is given. If no one knows how to give the injection, you should be taken to the hospital. You do need a prescription for a glucagon kit, but it is well worth it, especially those of you with type 1, in case that blood sugar really, really plummets and we need to get you awake in a hurry. You should be awakened in about 10 minutes after the glucagon is injected. If not, you need to be taken to the hospital at once. Well, I hope this has helped you to understand that what you can do if you have low blood sugar. Don't forget to get my new ebook, like this video, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you informative videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.